Hello everybody, this is Ultimate Lifeform RB, and welcome back to the Mega Man X3 playthrough. In our last episode, we took on Dr. Doppler Stage 3, and now for this episode, ladies and gentlemen, this is the finale. We are at the final stage of the game, and now it is time to once again take on Sigma. So, let's go ahead and get started. Now there's not going to be too much to this final stage. You do have this initial area filled with enemies, but after that, there's really nothing else but the final boss. So let's just go ahead and quickly make our way through here. So this is it, folks, the finale. And much like Mega Man X1, to get to Sigma, we need to do some wall jumping up a very tall shaft in order to get to where we need to be. Now before you get to the ensuing boss fight, switch to the spinning blade. That is going to be the weakness of this boss, so let's go ahead and get that weapon ready so we don't have to switch, and here we go. We meet again, X. It was easy to corrupt that fool, Doppler. And I would have succeeded if you hadn't interfered. But we are always destined to meet, aren't we, X? Let the eternal struggle begin! For the third time. Now this boss fight can be pretty daunting, but there is a method to cheese him. And basically, if you have the hyper armor, which allows you to do double air dashing, air dash across the room, wherever he is, and whatever wall he's facing away from, slide on that wall jump, and basically stay above his head, and launch the spinning blade. Because the spinning blade has a boomerang type effect, it will come back and it will hit Sigma. And by doing this method, you will almost never get hit. And when Sigma drops to about 50% health, in addition to launching fireballs, he'll also throw his shield, like Captain America does. And basically, once again, just keep wall jumping, stay as high as you can, and the shield will never touch you. So if you do what I'm doing here, you can pretty much cheese this boss relatively easily. But if you try to fight him toe-to-toe, he can be a pretty daunting challenge. And he's down! But if you've been watching my previous Mega Man X playthroughs, you should know that this is not the end of the fight. We're only just getting started. The next boss is even more intimidating. Well done, X, but I'm far stronger than my previous forms. Behold the power of the ultimate battle body! And to steal a quote from the Super Gaming Brothers, it looks like somebody sat down, started designing this thing, and never stopped. This is the battle body for Sigma that Dr. Doppler was talking about earlier. This is Kaiser Sigma. This is the final boss of Mega Man X3, and man is he daunting. This guy is huge. He has a wide variety of attacks that can really put the hurting on you. And the worst part about him is that he is only vulnerable to the X-Buster. And when I say vulnerable to the X-Buster, I mean charged X-Buster shots. Normal X-Buster will not do a thing to him. And the worst part is that there's only one vulnerable area on Kaiser Sigma's body, and it is his head. You can see how this is a problem because, well, look at the size of this thing and look at how small the head is in comparison. A very tiny hitbox you're aiming for. And basically the key to the fight is to wall jump, and once you reach a certain height, you need to fire off your charged X-Buster to hit Sigma. The thing is, you have to fire from a very precise spot. Basically, the key to the fight, the spot you want to aim for, will be the two large fin-like things or whatever protruding from his shoulders near his head. That is the part that you want to aim for. And you'll know when you hit him because his head will flash. Like right there. But this is a very daunting boss fight because he takes a lot of damage, and again, you have to be very precise when firing off the X-Buster. If you're even the slightest bit off with your charged X-Buster, you will not damage him. So this fight can be very long and very aggravating, depending on how things go. Arguably, his most damaging attack is actually the missiles, from my experience. Like, these missiles are doing a good number on me. And as you can see, when you get to this fight, you want to make sure you have your sub-tanks. You're going to need at least 3 sub-tanks, you know, if you really want to stand a chance. I say at least 3 sub-tanks. If you can, try to take as little damage as possible from the previous Sigma fight. And, you know, just hold on to as much health as you can, because you're going to need every last single bit of it in order to really stand a chance here. Luckily, the good thing about Kaiser's Sigma is that he does have a very predictable pattern. He'll always go up, he'll come down, and he'll go from side to side almost all the time. So that is in your favor. He is a very predictable boss. He's not like some kind of Dark Souls boss or whatever where he pulls something out, you know? Although Dark Souls bosses can be pretty predictable too when you really get down their patterns and stuff, so maybe that's not the best comparison. But basically, with this fight, it's going to be a long, grueling fight. Just keep at it, don't give up, and if you have to take a death, take a death. But try to hold on to like your sub-tanks and stuff as much as you can. One more good hit, and I miss with the Z-Saber. You can get him with the Z-Saber, but it's very hard to do it. Because the thing about the Z-Saber is that you cannot fire off the Z-Saber when you're attached to a wall. If you want to use the Z-Saber, you got to charge it up, and then immediately jump off the wall, and as soon as you jump, fire it. You have to be very precise with it, but it's really not worth the trouble, in my opinion. Just stick with regular charged X-Buster shots, and he's going to go down. But alas, we're still not done. If you can believe it, after all of that. No, it can't be! I can't even defeat you with this magnificent body? There seems to be only one choice now. I'll possess you! Now, as soon as this sequence begins, as soon as you gain control of X, hit the wall and just start wall jumping, because once again, it's the Sigma virus, just like we had to deal with in Mega Man X2, but this is not a fight. This is an escape sequence. So, basically, Sigma's going to try to bump you off the wall into the rising fire, so we don't want that to happen, and it just happened anyway. Luckily, since I have the hyper armor and stuff, I can actually afford to take the damage, but only so much. So we managed to make it out of there. So let's bust on out of here. I think we're done with this game. Or not. Damn, it's a dead end. Wow, cursing in a Nintendo game from the 1990s. Well, technically it's a Capcom game. Ha ha ha! Give up, X! I'll possess your body and rule the whole world! Oh, really, fool? A little spanner in the works! Argh! Your Doppler! How did you obtain this? How do you feel now, Sigma? Did you like my special vaccine for the Sigma virus? Now, a quick note about this cutscene. If Zero is still alive, he will actually come down and stop Sigma. But since Zero is dead, since we had to use him to get the Z-Saber, it's Doppler who's making this cutscene. X, I'm sorry to have given you so much trouble. I know I can never really atone for what I have done. But I will try to get things right by taking Sigma with me. Try to set things right. My program is fading. X, it's time to say goodbye. And everything's gonna go boom. I think we ought to get out of here. Yes, we do. So once again, the enemy HQ goes up in flames. Finally, this playthrough's done. But that's it, folks. Another chapter in the Mega Man X series is done. Now, this ending cutscene is also different whether or not you have Zero with you. If Zero is with you, he will actually join you when you're doing this cutscene. X has crushed Sigma's plan once again, but many questions still occupy his mind. So yes, much like Mega Man X and X2, you know, this is the part where X is going to reflect on everything. You know, why must humans fight against Reploids? Why must Reploids fight against each other? You know, he's going to be all mopey. As X stares at the burning remnants of Doppler's lab, his body trembles from an unknown sorrow. And that sorrow is... What does fate have in store for me, he wonders. Now, I wonder if the narration's different. Yeah, the narration's a little bit different depending on whether or not you have Zero. He can only hope that someday, Dr. Light's plan for him will finally be revealed. Unknown to X, his destiny has already been decided. Oh no, here's the part I'm expecting, I think. To save mankind, he must destroy Zero. Which looks like foreshadowing nowadays if you look at X4 and X5. But only time will tell when and why. I think that's actually maybe not a translation error, but I think in the original Japanese it doesn't say X has to destroy Zero, he merely has to fight him someday. Alright, so we have the X3 cast, the enemy roll call, and our look at the Mavericks of this game. And with this sequence, we've pretty much reached the end of the game, ladies and gentlemen. That is the conclusion of Mega Man X3. So now I've played all three Mega Man X games for the Super Nintendo, X1, X2 last year, now X3 this year. And I have had a pretty good time playing all three of them. And I guess at this point, I'll go ahead and give my thoughts on this little trilogy as a whole. Of the three X games, I do have to say X1 is still the very best. Near nothing beats the original. But in terms of X1 and X2, I find myself flip-flopping in terms of where I rank them. Sometimes I like X2, other times I prefer X3, I'm really not sure where to put them. Sometimes I rank the X3 games in order of release, you know, X1, X2, X3, you know, in that order. But sometimes I find myself preferring X3. You know, it's kind of like how the different concepts are. Like X2 had the X Hunters and stuff, and in this game you have Bit and Byte, and you have the stuff with the Z Saber, and like what decision you make, what weapons you use, how you play the game will influence the outcome, stuff like that. But this game's not the best game ever made. You know, it's not Ocarina of Time, it's not a masterpiece of a game, but I don't think it's bad. You know, I think it's probably in the middle of the road in terms of X games for me. It's, you know, it's not perfect, but it's a perfectly fine game. And I enjoy doing this playthrough. You know, I always say I enjoy doing these playthroughs, but I really do. This was a good game for me to try and continue the X series. And as we look at the Mavericks, I guess I'll go ahead and kind of go into whether or not I'm sure some folks are wondering if I plan on continuing the X series. The answer is maybe. Right now, well, recently I have been practicing with X4. Mega Man X4 was the first game in the X series to be released for the PlayStation 1. Although some regions did get X3 for the PlayStation, but it was with X4 that the X series truly made the jump from the Super Nintendo to the PlayStation. Right now, recently I have been trying to do some practice with X4, but I'm far from the point where I can really be confident enough to deliver a playthrough for that game. So a continuation of the X series for my channel might be waiting a while, but I do plan on getting back to this series at some point. But for the time being, the X series is going to get another rest with the conclusion of X3. God Car Machine Oenery is a boss that we did not get to see. That's an alternate boss. I'm still not sure at this point if I'm going to do an extra video featuring some of the alternate bosses, and I'm sorry for the screen going dark there, my Wiimote actually turned itself off. But I may or may not be doing a video showing some of the alternate bosses that we skipped over. But for all intents and purposes, I'm going to consider this playthrough done, since I've gone through the main part of the game. So there's Sigma and Kaiser Sigma. Sigma Virus, although we did not actually fight him this time, it was just an escape sequence. And that should be about the end of this. Mega Man X and Zero. And you. That should just about do it for this sequence. Thanks for playing, presented by Capcom. And ladies and gentlemen, that will be the conclusion of the Mega Man X3 playthrough. If you folks liked what you saw in this video, be sure to like, leave a comment, and tell me what you think. And if you followed this playthrough all the way through from beginning to end, be sure to give me your thoughts on this playthrough as a whole, and whether or not you would like to see me continue the X series with X4, X5, etc. So this is Ultimate Lifeform RB signing out for now. I will see all of you in the next video and the next playthrough. See you then! We'll be right back.